Around 700 miles from the North Pole, along Greenland's northwestern coastline, ice floes collide into a long, desolate fjord called Fólka. On the northern shore of the Fólka Fjord sits a remote, windblown area known as Ita.
In the winter, Greenland is a place only for those who know what they're doing. When the wind blows across a barren landscape like that, it can feel like a harsh and alien world.
In 2005, researchers noticed something unusual on a stretch of coast usually hidden by snow. They spot a dark, out-of-place pattern on the barren shore. Once on the ground, researchers find the eerie remnants of an ancient people. The oval foundations and tools they unearth belong to the ancient Tule, who are ancestors of today's Inuit. They began to arrive in Greenland around 1100 AD.
Like the Inuit, the Tule hunted and raised families in the harshest of Arctic conditions.
Almost everything they had was repurposed from large animals they hunted, like the polar bear, the walrus, the seal. They used the bones for tools, the skin for clothes and boats, and walrus oil for lamps.
They built dog sleds and had a simple drill technology for making holes.
But as researchers dig down further on the desolate Tule settlement, they uncover something unexpected. A cluster of four strange ivory carvings beside a pair of harpoons. Experts think the four carvings are of a sculpin fish, a polar bear, and two abstract-looking harpoon points. But they are found at a depth that predates the age of the Tule in this area.
They find them just below the Tule settlement level. This puts them at a time before it became an established Tule site.
Experts are at a loss to explain their existence. Who could have buried these out-of-place carvings? While digging on the settlement of an ancient Arctic people known as the Tule, experts find a rare set of carvings below the dig site that they are unable to identify.
Tule carved objects are almost exclusively female figurines or objects pertaining to their daily tasks in a hunter-gatherer society.
But these carvings use more traditionally male themes. Harpoons and fish and bears would have been within the male domain of hunting.
Researchers decide to continue their dig in the hopes of finding more clues.
Finding four carvings close together is very rare. It's almost like they've been placed there as a group on purpose, not just dropped by accident.
At the same level as the strange carvings, researchers find the telltale sign of an even more mysterious people. They discover unmistakable tools and objects belonging to a legendary group of Arctic inhabitants known as the Late Dorset.
Inuit oral histories describe a group of huge people who were taller and stronger than the Tule and wanted no contact.
It would be eerie and unsettling to be in such a barren and harsh place and to come across somebody and they just want to keep to themselves. Who are these people?
The Late Dorset people first arrived in Greenland around 800 AD, before the Tule. But over 400 years later, all traces of them vanish.
The weird thing is, scientists still don't know if the Tule and the Dorset ever coexisted, even though their settlement dates do seem to overlap.
It's very strange. Some believe the Tule assimilated the Dorset into their culture, while others believe the two groups never encountered each other.
The Late Dorset people vanish around the same time that the Tule people appear. So it's suspicious. But there must be something special about this place that makes both peoples want to live in this location.
Researchers scour the area for clues and realize that for a people living off the land, the location of Ita could have been an oasis. Ita sits near a polynya, a place that is open water year-round but is surrounded by sea ice. Polynyas attract a variety of wildlife, not just sea mammals, but land mammals and birds, like the little auk.
If you live here, it gives you a fighting chance to survive year-round, when existence elsewhere could be pretty grim.
It could easily be that this place had a ton of food, so it's worth fighting for.
Could there have been a conflict between the Thule and the Dorset for nearby resources?
There was a lot of evidence of tool making at the site from both the Dorset and the Thule, so we know that they both spent time in the area in both temporary and stone shelters.
But researchers have found no evidence at Ida of a battle. No weapons of war, no piles of bodies, no violently broken bones.
They haven't found evidence of late Dorset battles anywhere in Greenland. But if it wasn't a battle, how else could the population collapse so quickly? Experts are unable to explain how a mysterious Arctic people known as the late Dorset just disappeared after living in the area for 400 years.
Sometimes when an ancient people just vanish from an area like this, the explanation can be as simple as disease.
The Vikings were known to be in Greenland at that time. Could they have contracted a disease to which they had little immunity? It's possible.
But there's no proof. Almost no Dorset DNA has been found anywhere.
There are no bodies to study, which leads researchers to think the Dorset did not follow the custom of burying their dead.
They seem to have truly vanished, and the archaeological record just doesn't provide enough clues.
Faced with scant evidence, researchers turn to the mysterious cluster of four carvings to help shed light on why the Dorset vanished.
Maybe the two carved harpoon points found in the cluster can give us a clue as to their hunting techniques.
In some senses, the Dorset lived quite differently from other Arctic hunters that came before or after them. Researchers are baffled that they didn't use bow and arrow technology.
Instead of using bows, they would hunt primarily with harpoons. So a lot like polar bears, they would hunt in ice holes looking for prey like seals and walrus.
As opposed to the Thule, they didn't develop drilling technology, build boats, or dog sleds.
Maybe their lack of boat technology limited their harvesting of animals they otherwise could have hunted.
When you're an Arctic hunter living essentially hand to mouth, if you have a month of bad luck, things can quickly get desperate.
The carvings may hint at something more sinister. Despite living in an area teeming with wildlife, could the late Dorset have died from starvation?